Hey, Jason Morrell here. If you're in the scientific field and you're dealing with a lot of data, like hundreds or thousands or tens of thousands of bits of data, you might find that the XY scatter chart is the perfect tool for you. In our example here, we have a table showing the monthly rainfall in Timbuktu between the years 2000 and 2017. And just so you know, it's all made up. This is a formatted table, so I'm going to click any cell in the table. Excel will work out the boundaries for me. I'm then going to go to the Insert tab here and find the XY scatter options. Now, you've got quite a few options in here. After I've created the first one, I'll explore some of these others with you. But I'm going to choose this first one as a starting point. To make it easy to see, I'm going to move this chart to its own sheet. So on the Chart Tools Design tab, I'm going to choose Move Chart and specify New Sheet. And let's just call it XY scatter. Across the bottom, you have your years, going from 2000 through to 2017. On the vertical axis, the Y axis, you have your monthly rainfall in millimeters. There's no label for that yet, but we'll add that in a minute. This is a really good way to represent lots of data. As you can see, you've got your periods down here. Back on sheet one, each month was numbered 1 through to 12. And the reason I didn't put January, February, March in here is because the XY scatter never displays that information. It always just shows a single figure down the bottom here. So in a minute, it may be worth adding the extra numbers in here to represent all the numbers 1 through to 12 for your 12 months. If we look at this scatter chart, we can see that the monthly rainfall was highest in months 1 and 2 and 11 and 12. And it kind of dips towards the middle of the year there. But each month, the rainfall falls within a certain range, and it's fairly consistent across all the years. What XY scatter charts are very good at spotting is anomalies. That's data that doesn't really fit the mold. So if we go back to sheet one here, and let's just pick a value somewhere, let's take the very last cell, and make it something that's completely out of range, let's say 250. When we go back to the XY scatter, you can see there's one anomaly here which kind of stands out like a sore thumb from the rest of the data, because it really doesn't fit the pattern. Maybe somebody has typed it in wrong, or maybe the weather did something crazy that month. But for whatever reason, this is out of character, and we can spot it straight away on the XY scatter. So let's just tidy up a few things here. Down the bottom, let's add these extra months for the month numbers we don't currently have. So what I'm going to do here is to click the plus sign to show the chart elements. I'm going to show the grid lines, and I'm going to show the grid lines actually for major and minor for both directions. And that just fills in the detail for us a little bit. I'm then going to double click on the chart, which displays the right-hand side panel here. And I'm going to change chart options to the horizontal value axis. That's the one down the bottom. And under axis options here, I'm going to click this option here, which again says axis options, and open up axis options. So axis options appears in three places there. But in here, you'll see the units. So major and minor. Major is currently set to 2. And that's why it's only showing you 2, 4, 6, and 8. I'm going to switch this over to 1. Down the bottom, you can see that you've got all the numbers now from 1 through to 12. Also down the side here, we need a label to indicate what these numbers are representing, the monthly rainfall in millimeters. So to switch on the vertical axis title or label, I go to the plus sign here, go to my chart elements, and hover over axis titles here, and choose the primary vertical axis title. This adds a little text box over here, and in here, I can just wipe out what's there and type monthly rainfall in millimeters. So that's just tidying up your chart like you normally would. At the top here, there's lots of other options for displaying your chart in different ways. So there's different effects, different layouts, that kind of stuff. You may find that one of these works better for you. This one here, for example, is making all the data points glow. So again, you can see quite clearly that anomaly that we highlighted before. If we choose change chart type, we're still on the XY scatter category here. But at the top here, you've got lots of different types to choose from. So I could, if I wanted to, join up the dots. And that kind of shows the trend of the rainfall year by year for each month. So let's just do that as an example. And we'll just choose this. Now, it looks really messy first time through because we've got so much data on here. And again, you can see that anomaly shooting through on that last one. So what you probably want to do here is to trim this down a bit. You go to your filters here. So in here, you probably choose less years. So maybe you want to show the comparison every 5 years, as an example. You might deselect everything and then select, say, 2000, 2004, 2009, 2014, and just for the sake of it, 2017, and apply. And that way you get less of these lines. It's less cluttered and you can see the trends clearer. So that's XY scatter charts. Very good when you've got lots and lots and lots of data. Its main purpose is to consolidate all that data into a form that's readable, but also to highlight the stuff that doesn't fit the pattern, the anomalies in your data. Have fun.